Hello there and welcome back. Today we are going to be installing the first system into my new fish house. Now the first system is actually going to be a freshwater plant tray based system. It's going to be a tiered system with four different tiers for four different floating plants. You can see in this one here the general principle. We have a garden tray with a light over it, although this one is very, very basic and was just a trial to see if the principle worked. And as you can see with the amount of floating plants I've got, it does. So even though I'm going to be using this for keeping some shrimps in and floating plants, this system actually will be able to be used for pretty much anything you want. You could breed live bearers or shrimps in this system, or you could even use it as a saltwater coral tray system. So really very, very modular as to what you do with it. For the racking, we're going to be using C16 timber, which is planes timber, and this is 2 by 3 inches, not 2 by 4, 2 by 3. It's way strong enough and it's a little bit cheaper than 2 by 4, and we're going to be putting it into this corner. Now I am still getting a little bit of water seepage from the outside of this shed despite having sealed it. And everything else I've done to it, water is still coming through. To combat this, I'm going to need to get some guttering on the outside. However, what I'm going to do to begin with is just put this pond liner underneath as a barrier between the wood and moisture, and then I'll get the guttering in to solve the problem. However, putting this down for long term isn't a bad idea anyway, because it will protect my racking and things from any spillages and floods that I might have within the shed. So the trays I'm using for this system are these garden trays. Really, really good, very, very strong, and also cheap. The dimensions of this particular tray is 100 centimeters long, 55 wide, and I think 18 or something like that deep. Now, why am I using these trays rather than using glass? So firstly, it's just the fact that these are so much cheaper. When you start going into sort of commercial systems, although this is a very baby commercial system, you will find that not many places actually use glass tanks for culture. A lot of the time it's trays and tubs and things, purely because of the cost. This is about £15 a tray, whereas if I was to get a similar sized glass tank, we'd be looking almost at £100 per tray. So massive savings there. This is going to be a really basic racking system, nothing fancy or crazily difficult to do. So you can see here I made a rectangle of the wood that I bought, and that's just supporting at the base of this tub. Now the weight bearing is going to be along the sides, and on the end here it's not making any contact with the wood at all, because this is the part we're going to attach to the legs of the racking. So really quite simple. Now these tubs are only 80 litres, so I don't need to do anything particularly complicated to hold that weight. This wood alone is enough, and you can see here we've got some 70mm screws through the end, more than enough to support the weight that's going to be in these tubs. You can also see that these tubs are wider at the top, and actually this upside down, so this is the top, than it is at the bottom. So rather than put the wood around the lip, which I think over time would bend and flex and probably fail, I've decided to put the racking in contact with the base of the tub so that there's less chance of the tub changing shape and sort of squeezing itself out of the racking system. So I need three more of these rectangles, and then we're going to attach it to the legs and make it all secure and sturdy. Okay, so here's pretty much the racking done. In essence, you can see what I've done in terms of the design. It's so basic. So we've got four of those rectangles that I made, and I've attached them to some uprights simply, I've done that via screws through the rectangles and into the upright itself. Now attaching it directly to the uprights like that is the most basic way of doing it, and it's probably the weakest way of doing it. However, I don't need this racking to be massively strong. The other way of doing it would be to get a piece of wood like this one and put it underneath like that, and then you screw this piece of wood into the frame, the legs, and then you sit the rectangles onto that piece of wood. That is a stronger way of doing it, but I don't need to do it that way, and also it saves a bit of timber by not having those supports in this particular design. So racking is done. That is looking pretty good as far as I'm concerned. I'm actually pretty pleased how that's turned out. It is also incredibly heavy, and if I know anything, heavy means reliable. so it's going to work just fine. In terms of it being level, it is level to the degree of accuracy that I'm bothered about. The other side as well, you can see it's just a slight bit wonky towards the door, but it's within those two lines and that's good enough for me. So the next part is to actually get the tubs in, and they fit really well. What we need to do beforehand though is add these tank connectors. So these are 25 mil tank connectors, and that's how I'm going to pass water from the top all the way down to the bottom tray. So basically I'm just going to drill holes using my conical bit here, and I can go up to 26, I think, and that'll give me the right size hole for the tank connector, which is just there. Got three of those. The bottom tray, which is the tray that's currently in my shed, is going to be completely sealed because it doesn't need a tank connector in there. That'll be the last one that goes on. So one thing I've just noticed on these tank connectors is the fact that there's quite a large gap here, and I can't screw it up any further because of the molding on the inside. And it's quite a simple fix, and it's not something you should be afraid of doing. Just be careful of the thread when you're doing it. And all I'm going to do is just cut the thread slightly shorter, just using a hacksaw, nothing particularly difficult. And the reason I need to do it is because there's an inner lip at the bottom of this tank connector, and the thread's too long, essentially. So I'm going to shorten the thread, and that will allow it to be completely screwed tight. Okay, so I've just done all the fittings, and I'll just show you where we're at. So you can see at the top, we have the tank connector with a downpipe, and then that goes into this longer downpipe through the base of the tub. And then we're gonna flow over to the left, and then we have the same situation going down to that tub, flowing over to the right, and then we're going to finally get down to the bottom tub, which won't have any holes in it, which is currently in my shed with plants in. And you can see what I've done here is I've made the flow go from one end of the tub to the other, and that's to allow the water to move through the system all the way. We don't get any, or hopefully don't get too many dead spots in terms of flow. Pipe work's pretty simple. This is just 25 mil pipe which fits straight into there. I'm going to solvent weld this together on the down pipe. So I've got some of this PVC pipe cement. I'll just put a dab of that around each of the down pipes. The stand pipes I'm going to leave uncemented. I might put a little bit of plumber's tape just to make it a tighter fit, but you don't always have to do that. Sometimes they're a tight fit, but this one's a little bit loose, so a bit of plumber's tape will just help seal that. And the reason I'm not going to cement this part is because if I want to drain this tub at any point, all I have to do is remove the standpipe and we can drain it at least down to that level. The standpipe is just slightly below the top lip of the tub, and that's because the water level will always be slightly above where the standpipe lays. Now this is a bit of a fiddly thing. Sometimes you might have to, once filled, actually recut these to be slightly lower, but I'm fairly confident that this will be the right level straight away. One thing I might do later on is add a 90 degree elbow onto here and just have the water pointing in that direction or that direction, just to reduce noise, because these straight pipes sometimes they can be quite noisy, and putting an elbow there can just help reduce that water splashing effect and air and things like that. But we'll see how it runs, and we can adjust that later on. What I do now is cement everything with the PVC pipe cement, add a little bit of plumber's tape, and then we're going to fill her up and see how she holds water. So we've got the hose on now, we're just going to fill her up. What we're checking for is leaks around the tank connectors, and that, well, that's the main one really. We don't want it leaking out from the base of the tank connector. The PVC glue has gone off. It only takes about 20 minutes to go off, so that'll be fine. That's really the only place I'm going to expect a leak, will be from around the tank connector. And we're also going to check the height of the water. We're just going to let it run all the way through the system down to this tray, and then obviously we're not going to let it overflow yet because there's no bottom tray, and hopefully there'll be no leaks. It'll all be at the right level, and then we can move the plants and things over from my current tray in my shed into this system, and then we'll fit the filtration and the lighting. Okay, so we're filling up and it's all running really well. It's a little bit bubbly, but that's to be expected. We can sort that out later with baffles and 90 degree elbows and things, But the important thing is it's not leaking, and also it's pretty level in terms of the water. I have had to solvent weld the pipes in actually, because the plumber's tape wasn't giving me the tight fit that I wanted. However, I shouldn't think that should be a problem. And also I have reduced the level of the downpipes by an entire centimeter, because they were just slightly too high. So the next step, before we add the lighting and the filtration, we're going to take a few of each plant from here, probably get rid of the rest of them, and then we will have to transfer this tray over. There are some shrimp in here, I'm not really sure what type, just some random wild type cherry shrimps I think, and a couple of sailfin mollies. So we'll transfer them over, and then we can set up the filtration and the lighting. So the whole reason for me doing this system as fresh water is purely I need somewhere to put my plants, and also I need somewhere to put all of my shrimps. You can see here, since I set this tank up, I've had a shrimp population explosion, but I'm not really doing anything worthwhile with this tank other than breeding shrimp in here, and I can do that in my tubs. And that's really the reason. Otherwise I would have done that system as a saltwater system, but I like the shrimps and I would quite like to experiment with freshwater floating plants. Let's help this beetle out of here. I shouldn't really be in there. Come here, you. Yeah, I kind of want to experiment with aquarium floating plants. I haven't really done much other than Amazon frog bit, and they're quite tricky when you get them going because of the nutrient needs of them, especially when they're growing really quickly. So we're going to experiment with four different types. I've got some salvinia here, and we'll put that in one of the trays and see if we can keep them all alive. So this is what's in the tub after I've removed the plants. Two sailfin mollies. I'll put them into the 4 foot because obviously this plant system is not mature or anything, so they can't go in there yet. And we've got lots of shrimp. So there's a nice red cherry shrimp. I think there's two of those, another one there, but the rest of them are just wild type, so I'm not that bothered. I'll put them in the bottom tray so that when I've got the shrimps above them, which I do like, all the spares I guess will just fall into the bottom tray. They'll all breed and maybe they'll come out with something interesting, but by the looks of it, these two red cherry shrimps for some reason are kicking out wild types, which is very disappointing. So we've filled, we've got plants moved over. Another thing I've done is put this mesh around the downpipes. It's a cylindrical filter mesh actually. Really useful, stops plants and fish and all sorts of things going down the spout. So that's useful. I've only got two pieces of that. I need to buy some more for the top bit. In terms of lighting, it's going to be a mishmash of what I've got laying around, but I do have some nice things laying around, so we're okay. The first one I've got is a fluval plant 2.0, the Bluetooth one, so that can go on there. We've got an aqua sky, which is probably the worst light I have. It's quite an old aqua sky, so it will still grow plants, but I'm not expecting much at the moment from that. And then we've got two of these, which are really good. These are Voguec grow lights. I bought two as an experiment to see how they would grow plants, and as you saw on the other tub, this one grew really well. There's two types. There's a short bulb one, which I've got that, and then there's a long bulb one. I bought one of each just to see the difference. I think in terms of output they're the same, but obviously that stretches the light a bit further and that's a little bit more condensed. They're really, really nice lights actually. They've also got inbuilt timers, very good clips to hold them in place, so we're going to put them on. Okay, we've got the lighting going and you can see the difference in the lighting already. The bottom and the top lights are fluval lights, and then the middle lights are those plant lights. I actually prefer the look of those plant lights. What I'm going to do probably is buy two more of those clip lights so it all matches and looks the same. However, for the moment, I think we're pretty good. I'll just show you what the lighting's like. So the aqua sky is actually a Bluetooth, so it's a newer one, and to be fair, I think that's going to be all right. It looks pretty bright, doesn't it? So we'll grow plants quite nicely under that. These lights are awesome. I really do like them. You can see you can adjust all the spread, and we know that they grow plants because we've seen it happen, so that's cool. And then the middle one, we've got the same idea. These ones with the bigger bulbs tend, or the fatter bulbs anyway, tend to be a bit more top heavy. So I've had to use a screw here just to hold one of the bulbs in place. But the spread of light's good. So this one's got frog bit in it. I think I've missed a bit of dwarf water lettuce there. And then at the bottom, this is the tray that was running. That's why it's dirty. You can see there's some algae in there, but I'm leaving that because that's going to help to add bacteria to the system. There's also some snails, but what can you do about snails? And this one's got salvinia in it. And this one has the fluval plant LED. I'm going to replace this one definitely because, one, it's too long for the system. So we've got some light overspill. And also, the power supply is humming. And the light on the power supply doesn't work. So that worries me that possibly that the power supply is on its way out. So I'll buy another couple of these and then we'll all match and we'll all look great. But for the minute, I think it looks pretty cool. It's a good start to the fish house build. So it's all looking pretty good. I've got a really rubbish pump on there at the moment. I'm gonna change that pretty much tomorrow. This was just to see if it worked, and it does, the system works. You've got water flowing from level to level. It's all working really nicely, no major leaks. All the water on the floor is just because I am really careless when it comes to using hoses, and I've spilt water everywhere, but it's fine, doesn't matter. So yeah, looking really, really nice. Only thing to change is the pump, because this is just not going to work. I might buy quite a large external canister pump or something, or a pond pump maybe, and use that for the pumping. However, everything else is really nice. So let me know what you think of it. It was quite a long build actually. It took me about 10 hours to do this from start to finish. But it all went pretty smoothly, all pretty simply. A lot of the stuff I had laying around anyway, so not too bad. Leave a comment below what you think, what I should change, if you think it's totally rubbish and I should just get rid of the whole thing. So thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Leave a like and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Once again, thanks for watching and happy fish keeping.